know why.
I've just seen Lord Sugar waiting to speak to us there. I hope that's
a
smile.
Oh, now he's smiling.
That's
he's cracked a smile. That's better. you had all scared, my lord.
Are we on?
We're not supposed to be.
Sorry, I've just been patiently waiting for you. I know, but tempus fugit, they say.
No, because the thing is, you came up in the screen and Sean had a quick look to make sure everything was there, okay, technically, and your face was set in what one can best describe as a relaxed pose, which can be a little bit intimidating at times.
Yes, well, I was, you know, impatience is not
I know, time is money, time is money. We're going to get on with it straight away, Lord Sugar, because we're going to brush up our business speak. We're prepared to give 110%. The Apprentice is back.
The new series starts tonight on BBC One with 16 budding tycoons flexing their entrepreneurial muscles. And this year, Lord Sugar is taking on the recession, considering candidates who've been made redundant or have had a business fail.
You've seen him already, and we're going to speak to Lord Sugar shortly. First, we're going to take a look at tonight's programme. Here it is.
Guys, let's do something. Which is the stock take?
But Dan, we're not going to make any money by counting this up. We've got to start selling stuff.
Yeah.
Right. At the end of the day, one of them...
What they need to know is how much stock they've got, so we can be on the road.
Why can't one of them count it?
Because they're selling. They're selling now.
Yeah, but all four of them are selling. Three of them are having a chat.
Isn't doing anything. We're not going to get anywhere for the next 15 minutes. Let's get it done. Well, give them a finger. We know where we stand.
Okay. Let's do it.
Yeah. Right, OK, so we'll start off then with the pork and mustard, please.
All four of us are doing a stock take. Now, we're wasting time trying to go and sell. We should be going over then selling.
There's a whole box.
Poorly organised, poorly managed. And you know what? As far as I'm concerned, we've wasted like half a day anyway just faffing about.
That's the boys' team. Let's talk to Lord Sugar. You said later they were squabbling like old washerwomen. What is it about them?
Well, I think it's panic, Sean, really. They don't do themselves a favour, some of these people, because they're quite intelligent, very intelligent, and they do have the business acumen about them. The trouble is that they don't have any time to do things, because I sprung this on them. They didn't realise this task. You'll see tonight, if you watch, that they actually had to work right the way through the night. They came into the boardroom, sitting there all comfortable, thinking they're going to go back to the house and have a little cocktail party, but instead I said to them, no, you're off right now, and you've got to work through the night. So they were up 24 hours. But apart from that, it's this panic. It's this kind of got to get things done on time and a lot of jockeying for position of egos, really. Yeah. And that's why, you know, we end up getting a good candidate that at the end who actually can take all this situation of throwing them in the deep end.
Yeah. Pressure, clearly, putting people under pressure is a good test. Is it the best test of business acumen, though?
Yeah, it is. It's not a bad one. It's not a bad one, I've got to tell you, because things do change. If life is not as simple, otherwise we'd all be sitting on our yachts in the south of France and flying our private jets around. It is pressure, and it's seeing a person, how they perform under pressure, is really part of the process, in seeing how they can cope with... kind of things that are thrown at them, and also dealing with the other team members.
What's noticeable as well about this series is it's got a couple of candidates who've been made redundant. So there's a very real sense that they've experienced what it's like in the business world, and it really isn't easy.
Yeah, I mean, that we set out to acknowledge the difficult economic times. So we, as you quite rightly say, we've got some... one person there was made redundant, another person who had a business that failed due to the economic times, a couple of very young people that have done all their university training and all that type of stuff and just simply couldn't find themselves jobs because there was no jobs going. So there's an opportunities there, and we felt that that was the right thing to do, bearing in mind these economic times.
All right, we've taken a look at the boys. Let's have a quick look at the girls, because they also have a spot of tension.
What numbers are we talking about there? Sorry, I'm Joanna.
Oh, this is our team leader,
Dan,
Joanna.
Hi, pleased to meet you too. What would you prepare to buy from us today then, Dan?
A couple of kilo, if they were good.
OK, you guys, I want you to go round the businesses and carry on selling. So if all four of you can go...
Listen,
yes.
I feel my customer, we went there and pitched to him. I would like to finish it with him. So you're aware of the time constraints. Go out and sell whilst we finish our
No, customer. I'm not doing that. We're all a team. It doesn't matter who closes it. As long as the deal's done, well,
I do a lot of business and I do not.
Well, as long as the deal's done, I've not got a big ego. I don't need to close it.
It's not about ego.
Well, I personally believe that it is, and I'm confident that I could leave it to any of my team members.
It's not about me. It's a matter of professionalism.
So
I do not breathe.
So every sale you have to close.
100%. What, you open a deal with someone and you don't close it?
Of course. I wasn't trying to steal your thunder. It would have been noted.
All right. We're just going round in circles. Let's just agree to disagree and we'll carry on selling because we don't want to waste any more time, all right?
Argument's not too bad, though, is it, so long as it's constructive?
Yeah, I would always... A healthy argument, I've always said. A good, healthy argument. And once the argument's over, that it should be over and get on with it, because it's not real arguments in the sense of you hate each other or some kind of matrimonial, issue. It's a business discussion, and if you don't agree with someone in business and the colleagues that you're working with, you should be able to argue it out and then move on.
I saw a documentary about you, Lord Sugar, a couple of days ago where your wife was talking about watching you on The Apprentice, and she says she finds it quite difficult because she thinks you're really lovely, and she says when she watches you on the programme, you come across quite differently.
Well, you know, Sean, the thing is that the producers have got to make a programme. They've got to make an hour-long programme. We have over 110, sometimes 130 hours of film goes on to make one episode. Really? And it has to be condensed down to a one-hour show. And the boardroom scenes obviously go on much longer than you see in the final edited version. That's the way they portray me. Although this year, I think you might find a slightly little bit more humour as we go along.
Yeah, you're a teddy bear, really. We know that,
I know you know that.
Just one last.
I didn't want to say it myself. You know?
One last thing. Sir Alan used to trip off the tongue so easily. What do they call you in the boardroom now? Because you really are your Lord Sugar, your Alan Lord Sugar. Do they call you my Lord? What do they say?
No. Well, you're quite right, Bill. That people can't get out of the habit of calling me Sir Alan. And I fully understand that, because they've seen me on TV for so many years. The actual correct title at the moment is Lord Sugar. That's the correct title. To my friends and people I've known for years, I'm Alan, obviously. Even my wife. They call me Lord Sugar in the boardroom. And my ethos has always been this. Before I was Sir Alan, I always had this thing that, employees. Young people that came to work for my company who I hadn't known for a while, they would have to call me Mr. Sugar. Some of the ones that I started my business with obviously called me on first name terms. So I became Sir Alan, they had to call me Sir Alan. And now Lord Sugar, they call me Lord Sugar. I believe in all that stuff. I know the Americans are very friendly. They call each other by their first names. Maybe I'm a bit old-fashioned.
Yeah. All right. Lord Sugar.
Thank
Sugar,
you very much.
My Lord, your Lordship. All those. Thanks very much for joining us. Thank you. And The Apprentice.